Okay, girls, can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, what the genera we studied yesterday?
Development of this product.
Aim genera. Which genera we studied? Aim plant chadukunna nenu. Marsilia. Okay, done. So, what type of Marsilia plant it is? What type of a pteridophytic plant? Aquatic. Okay, we can call it as an hydrophyte. Pteridophytic, hydrophytic plant. It grows in the water. Okay, next. So, what type of a plant we have studied yesterday here? Does it have a stem? Does the Marsilia have a stem?
Yes, ma'am.
Stem untada? Roots. Okay. Next, how are the leaves? The characteristic feature of the Marsilia plant, the leaves at long night. Is it a simple leaf or a compound leaf? Smile, chappandi. Is it a simple leaf or a compound leaf?
Compound leaf.
Yeah, it is a compound leaf. How many different characters is going to have this long petiole? This is a long petiole. At the tip of the petiole, you can see the arrangement of these leaves in the form of a cross manner. You can see the leaflets are arranged in the form of a plus or cross manner. Okay. And what is this one called as? You can see here the
coiling.
Okay, what is this, ma? What is this called as? What is this called as? The younger leaves, they are folded inside. They are coiled. That process is called as what? This one is called as circinate vernation, which is a characteristic feature of the Marsilia plant. The younger plants are undergoing coiling. Okay. Right. Now, we have also covered regarding the internal or the anatomy of the rhizome yesterday. Now, how was the rhizome here? What is the characteristic feature here of the rhizome? So, it is going to have a single epidermal layer and the cortex region is getting surrounded by here with the help of the air enchyma, presence of the air cavities, and inner cortex is made up of sclerenchymatous cells. And internally, we can see the inner cortex, which is also of parenchymatous or pleurenchymatous region. And it is having a single layer of endodermis. And the steel, we studied about the steel of this as amphiploic amphiploic solenosteel. That means to say the xylem is getting divided into outer xylem and the outer phloem, whereas there's a endodermis is also of a single layered and the pericycle is also a single layered. That is a characteristic feature of the amphiphoic solenostelic condition. That is very important here. Now, next we go for the Marsilia petiole. Yesterday we have not completed this. So, Marsilia petiole tears. If you make practical slow kuda, you will do this one. Okay. Taking the transverse section of the Marsilia petiole. So, ikkada meeku em kanapadutundi picture lo chudandi. It is almost circular in outline, having a single layer of epidermis. And here also in the petiole, you can see the presence of the air chambers, which is a hydrophytic character. Air chambers, you can see, which is of the outer cortex. And the outer cortex is only a single layer, which is of hypodermis in thickness. Hypodermis layer antamo. Middle cortex is composing of the air enchyma. And the inner cortex here, it is made up of the parenchymatous tissue, where it consists of the made up of the it is of a solid tissue made up of several cells in thickness. And another important point here is it is filled with the starch. You can see here, these are the cells which are filled with tannins or the starch grains. So that is an important characteristic feature. Now next to come to the steel. So when we talk about the steel, it is somewhat triangular in outline and it is of protostelic condition. So without any pith, pith is absent in the center. And we can see the presence of two distinct arms of the xylem, which is in the form of V-shaped. So each arm, it is provided with the metaxylem elements in the center and protoxylem at both the margins. And the protoxylem is exact. So you can see here, this is one vascular, that is a xylem. This is one vascular xylem and this is another vascular xylem. So it is in the form of a V shape. They show the two distinct vascular, the xylem vessels in this form. Okay, now, so they are in the form of a V shaped where the metaxylem is in the center and the margin. So ikkademo metaxylem untundi and the margins of this is going to have the protoxylem. So in the Marsilia petiole, the xylem is represented as the exarch xylem. Now, xylem here, it is all surrounded by the phloem and the phloem is externally surrounded by single layer of pericycle and a single layer of endodermis. So this is regarding the Marsilia petiole. So don't get confused with the rhizome and the petiole. Rhizome lo kuda meeku air chambers untayi. And here also in the petiole, there are also air chambers. But how you can identify ante with the stelar condition. Akademo manaki rhizome lo nemo steel. We see the presence of two endodermis layers, two pericycle layer, and the outer phloem and the internal xylem. So that is called as amphiphloic solenostele. Kani ikkada just petiole lo simple protostelic condition where the xylem will be surrounded by the phloem. Two distinct xylem we can see here. Two distinct xylem vessels can be seen. So that is the main characteristic, which is in the form of V shape. So the main characteristic feature of the Marsilia petiole. Next to leaf, yesterday also we studied, that is a transverse section of the leaflet. It shows the presence of the upper epidermis as well as the lower epidermis surrounded by the cuticle. Again, this is a hydrophytic character. Next to below the two epidermal layer, in between them, you can see the central mesophyll tissue, which is divided into palisade parenchymatous tissue. And this is the spongy tissue. Okay, so which is a characteristic feature, the same type of we can see in the angiospermic leaf also. This is a palisade tissue where all the parenchymatous cells are elongated like this. And there are no intercellular spaces. The cells are all are compactly arranged side by side. So that constitutes a palisade tissue. Whereas in the spongy tissue, that is in the spongy parenchyma, we can see the cells are arranged in a linear fashion, but with the help of the intercellular spaces or the air spaces in between. And we can see a single vascular bundle in the center with a simple xylem surrounded by the phloem tissue. That's it. So this is regarding the internal structure of the leaf we studied yesterday. Next, reproduction, we studied with the sporocarp. Sporocarp and danger pump. Sporocarp is a fruiting body-like structure which is going to produce the sori. Okay, this is a fruiting body structure which will be developing at the base of the petiole with the help of a pedicel. Okay, it is going to have a pedicel. It is a kidney-shaped structure with a hard stony capsule and which is going to inhibit. And sporocarp lopala manaki em kanapadutunayi? We can see the presence of these sori. Sori ante em cheppamo? It is a sac-like structure. Sori is a sac-like structure which are going to consist. And each sori lo, we can see the presence of the sporangium. Okay. So we can see as many as 5 to 6 sori, which are alternating together. Totally about 10 sori, we can say approximately, which are in alternate position, lying side by side within the sporocarp. Now, within the sori, you can see the sporangium here. The development of the sporangium here is eusporangiate type. So, I think I'm going to say, what is this eusporangiate development? Eusporangiate development and in Japan. That means to say they are developed from a single initial. Okay, right. So inside this sporangia, you can see that is inside the sori. You can see two different types of sporangium. One is called as megasporangium, and the another one is called as the microsporangium. So you can see here. Megasporangium and the microsporangium, which are attached with the placenta. And each sori here, they are getting surrounded by a common layer or a nutritive tissue, what we call it as the indusium. This is a common layer. Each sporangium has its own indusium. Okay, or the indusial wall layer. Next, we'll go for the development of the sporocarp also. We studied this yesterday. That is, it is developed from a single initial, which is called as the archisporial initial, from which the jacket or the initial cells will develop. So that leads rise to the sporangia. Okay. Megasporangia develops into the male gametophyte, and the microsporangia develops into the female gametophyte. So when you talk about the when we talk about the male gametophytic development, we have studied this one. So this is a microspore which is formed from the microsporangia. This microspore will undergo a transverse division, forming a smaller cell and a bigger cell. Smaller cell, already I told you that it is of prothallial in origin, or the first formed cell, and the apical cell divides and further forms the jacket layers and also the androcytes or the androcyte mother cells. So from this androcyte mother cells, which undergo reduction division and are going to produce the male gamete, what we call it as the antherozoids. So you can see here the antherozoids, they are spirally coiled and possess the flagella, which are motile. Now when we go for the female gametophyte that is a development, so this is a megaspore developed from the megasporangia. So I already told you that from a single megasporangia, only one megaspore will be functional. Okay. So that functional megaspore will undergo division and produces the smaller cell and the large prothallial cell. Now this prothallial cell is always under the nutritive function. That way, it will produce the food material, or it will supply the food material to the dividing tissue or the dividing cells. Now, this small apical cell or this small cell, this will undergo further division and forms the apical cell and the basal cell. Now, this basal cell, it will undergo the longitudinal division and produces the lateral cell, and the apical cell will get transformed into the archegonial initial. Now, when we go for the further development, the basal cell will divide further and forms the jacket layer, and this archegonial initial, it divides further and forms the inner cell and the cover cell. Now, this inner cell, when you talk about the cover cell here, it will divide and forms the two neck initial. That is, they are developing further and forms the neck and the neck canal cells. Whereas this inner cell, this will be developing and further forming the ventral canal cell and the egg cell. Whereas the surrounding jacket layers, if they are forming a single layer and get transforms into the archegonium, that is a female sexual organ, which is going to have this female gamete called as the egg cell. So this is called as the mature archegonium. Now when we go for the fertilization, now each megaspore, it is going to consist of a well-developed oosphere or the egg, which is a female gamete. Whereas at the time of fertilization, this neck canal cell, ventral canal cell, they both will degenerate and it will produce a mucilaginous substance. So with the help of this mucilage, the anthrozoids, which are liberated into the water from the male gametophyte, these anthrozoids, they move, that is, they will motile, and among that, one of the anthrozoid will enter into the archegonium, which is going to consist of the female gamete called as the egg, and it will fertilize with that and produce the zygote or the oosphere. Now this oosphere, it will now further, now this is the starting stage of the sporophytic generation. Now this oosphere, what it is showing, it divides and produces four cells. Now among those four cells, I'll show you here the diagram, right? So this is a fertilized oospore or the fertilized egg, which is transforming into the zygote. So on this zygote, it undergo first one transverse division, and later on another transverse division, forming the four celled stage. Okay, now among these four cells, two cells, we call them as two sister cells, they develop the stem and the cotyledon, that is the rhizome. That is another two cells, they develop into the root. Now the vegetative cells of the gametophyte, they all form the calyptra, that is a covering layer of the cells. Now this calyptra, it forms an envelope, or it acts just like a covering sheet for the developing. So this is all the calyptra. And the megasporangium chuttu unna tissue anta kuda, it get transforms into the calyptra or the surrounding tissue. Now this calyptra, it forms the envelope around the developing embryo. Now, so from this embryo, the surface cells develop long rhizoids. Cotyledon and the root grow faster and come out of it in the form of a conic form. So conic form and student idanta kuda. Okay, this is the root and the shoot, that is the cotyledon and the root, they are coming out from the calyptra in the form of a cone like structure, whereas this is the root entering into the ground or entering into the soil or the bottom of the plant, that is the soil surface. Now this cotyledon expands to form the first simple leaf, and the primary root is getting replaced with adventitious roots, whereas the stem, it grows horizontally on the soil and forms a rhizome. Yes. So you can see here, this is all the calyptra. It will go. One it will develop into three. This is the cotyledon and the calyptra, and this is the stem. Develop into the further tissue. Now next comes to the alternation of generation. That means now the sporophyte and the gametophyte, they are, these two generations, they are alternating with each other. So Marsilia, as the dominant plant body, is a sporophyte. A diploid sporophyte, so we call it as a diploid plant. It is a heterosporous, that is, it produces two different types of spores, megaspores and microspores. On meiosis, they are developing into a haploid gametophyting plant. Now, the gametophyte of the Marsilia is dioecious. That means to say, the microspores gives rise to male gametophyte, and the megaspore give rise to a female gametophyte. So we can see two gametophytic generations here. Now the male and the female gametophyte, they complete the development and produce the gametes, male and the female gamete. The male gamete, we are calling it as anthrozoids, and the female gamete, we are calling it as the egg. Now these gametes are fused and forming a diploid oospore, which is called as the zygote. Now this oospore, it develops into embryo, and this embryo develops into the new sporophytic plant. So this is the life cycle of Marsilia. You can have a diagrammatic representation here. So this is the matured adult Marsilia sporophytic plant. So in this, the most important reproductive part of this plant is the sporocarp. So within this sporocarp, we are going to find many sori, which inhibits the presence of sporangium. So we can see here, there are two different types of sporangium. The smaller one, I'm calling it as microsporangium. Bigger one is called as the megasporangium. So from this microsporangium, the microspore mother cell will undergo reduction division and forms the microspore. Whereas the megaspore mother cell, it also undergo reduction division and forms the megaspore. Microspore develops into a male gametophyte here. Megaspore will develop into a female gametophyte. Now this male gametophyte produces the male gamete, what we call it as is antherozoids or the spermatozoids. And the female gamete consists of the archegonium, which is consisting of the egg cell inside it, which is a female gamete. Now the antherozoids, with the help of the flagella, they move or enter into this archegonium, fuses with this egg, and results in the formation of a diploid zygote. Now this zygote will undergo development and produce a simple primitive sporophyte, which will develop and produce back into the, or it will develop into a new sporophytic plant. So this is the life cycle of the Marsilia plant. So here we can see it is considered as a diplohaplontic life cycle. That means diploid phase of the sporophyte is alternating with the haploid phase of the gametophyte. So that we call it as the diplohaplontic life cycle.